children as a humble metaphor for how you gain salvation. Would you humbly come to Christ and say, what do I need? And would you help me with that? I give my life to you. And so certainly, Serenity Rose is such a precious little one. I bet you she never cries and never has any changes herself, I'm sure, by me. So, well, we want to take a time to pray. It's true to have you guys with us as well. My heart today, as they mentioned to me last night, they, many, many years ago, dedicated one of their four children, John being the oldest, dedicated him to the Lord. So it's a blessing for his folks to see John grow up and graduate and be used of the Lord. And now their desire to receive as well. We have this little one as well. Walk in the way to the Lord. And that's their desire. Okay, let's pray together, church. Let's pray for this family and all their desire to raise Serenity. God, thank you again for the privilege it is to dedicate another little life to you. This does not mean that she's getting salvation by any means, but it's certainly a commitment as a mom and dad that became their life to Christ. Thank you for John's mom and dad being here and being able to see the fruit of their labors in John's life and how John and Christy desire to continue on in raising their children in the nurture and admonition of the Lord, that they need the wisdom of Solomon, and need the patience of Job, and certainly the courage of David, and the humility of Ruth. Thank you for the wisdom that you have promised to give. We ask to do this for them, with the Serenity Rose, thank you for the little life. And it's beyond us when we hear and see in our own country the abortion rate. The sadness that you have in your heart. Thank you that we have families that are committed to raising them in the environment that someday when their heart's open, understanding spiritually the spiritual things that you would turn their heart to you. We love you. We need you now. And bless the service of all we do in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay, can we come? Let's start with this. We do have scripture. Turn to 1 Timothy chapter 4. I do know that because that's what I'm preaching on today. 1 Timothy chapter 4.
We love to read the scriptures together, so open your Bibles if you would. 1 Timothy chapter 4. Our pastor's been preaching out of 1 Timothy, and last week he talked to us from chapter 4. And last week we saw some very serious words that Paul is sharing with his son in the faith of Timothy. He continues those.